My name's Alex Camarena, and I play drums for Silent Planet. They were super... Well, first of all, Zach just killed me with kindness, pretty much. Even before I was with SJC, he was, like, around us, like, helping us out with everything. He would help me out, like, setting up drums that weren't even SJC. So stuff like that, like, to me, goes a long way. So. And then just on top of that, I've heard a lot of really good things about SJC, and from my short experience so far, it's been super rad. They genuinely care about, like, their artists and stuff, so, and that's, family is a big thing to me, so. Oh man, my kit, I'm a huge, like, vintage fan, so I wanted everything to be vintage, like, or at least kind of vintage. So I got, it's all, like, a chocolate stain, so it's just like a stain finish. And it's a 24 by 14 kick, a 13 by 8 rack tom, and a 16 by 14 floor tom. They all have the claw hoops, the wood hoops. All the wood hoops have like an H pearl inlay, so it looks super classy. The double-ended beaver tails, I've always been like a huge, I'm like a very, like I said, I love vintage drums, and it just like, every time I set it up, it looks just super vintage, and I got the rounded edges, so it's like nice and vintage, I guess.
Yeah.
Keyword vintage. I love vintage drums. To me, it's kind of like my escape. Oh, your tour manager's throwing coins.
I was like, wait, raining coins.
For me, it's like my escape. A lot of people always ask me like what I think about or what's going through my mind when I'm playing drums. And the truth is, there's honestly nothing going on, which is very liberating. Like, you kind of forget about everything. You forget about kind of like the world's problems and stuff, and you just kind of exhaust yourself playing. And that, I don't know, I think that's my favorite, just because I kind of get lost in just playing drums. And for those 30 minutes that I'm playing, like, I don't think about any other thing that I have going on in my life, or any of life's problems, I guess. It's just kind of like me playing drums, so
yeah.
I very much enjoy that. I've always been a less is more kind of guy. I'm so much more a sucker for like creativity and like just pocket drumming. So most of like my favorite drummers do just that. Like most of their bands or whatever band they play in, they literally kind of just, they more so complement the music and complement the other like instruments, and just kind of stay in the pocket, like instead of kind of like being super flashy. Yeah, that's a big thing for me. I kind of just tend to, I try and think about, I like tend to think about what people like when I first hear a song part. I hear it and I'm like, all right, this is like what your mind automatically goes to when you hear this. And then I just try and change it up a bit. Like, I try and write parts to where you hear them and you're like, oh, I would have never thought of this kind of drum beat for this part. So that's kind of my thing. I value creativity much more over like shredding and like being super crazy on it. Oh man, there's so many. For the last like year or two, it's been Aaron Sterling. He plays for like small bands like John Mayer, like Taylor Swift, stuff like that. There's always Aaron Spears. I love Aaron Spears a lot. Recently, I've gotten back, a huge like influence of mine growing up was Nate Young from Amberlin. So recently, I've been like looking up a bunch of videos of him again and just like watching him play drums. And, man, who else? Vinny Caliuta is like the best drummer in the world. So I love watching his videos. I'm trying to think of more. I love Aaron Gillespie growing up. I think every drummer does. Yeah, those are a few off the top of my head. Aaron Sterling is by far definitely my favorite for the last 2 or 3 years. I just can't get enough of that guy. Keep grinding, man. Keep practicing. If anything, I would say like have fun too. Like, once kind of like the fun gets sucked out of it, like it just kind of becomes a burden at that point. Like, I feel like you just have to be having fun with it. and practice so much. I remember early on when I started playing drums, my dad would make me practice for a long time every day. And looking back, I'm like thankful for it because I don't ever practice now.
Yeah.
And it's really bad, but it allowed me to do what I do now. So practice, even if it's like small things like rudiments or anything like that. And I know for me, like watching videos of favorite drummers is how I learned a lot. Like I'm self-taught, so I'm a visual learner. Like when I see somebody do it, it's how I kind of learn how to do it. So freaking go into the dark YouTube freaking drum channel, man, and just start looking up drum videos and your favorite drummers, like try and pick up things from YouTube videos.